Good stuff. We are in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Revolving Door is the restaurant that joins us in the kitchen. Chef Josh Berman is here, and he's got a lot of stuff that he's going to put together. What are we making today?
Today we're going to do a seared scallop with a melange of local squashes.
It's a fancy word you're throwing at us.
Melange just really just means mixture in French. But it's kind of a nice way. We're doing some really nice things. We've got a kabocha squash or a buttercup. We have an acorn and delicata. So.
All right, we can see these here, taking a look at these. Are the tastes any different than regular squash that we would have?
Well, I mean, regular squash, I mean, there are a ton of different squashes.
Or the squash that most people are kind of used
to having. So like butternut squash some things like that. It's all very similar. I tried to take some of the softer skin ones. Okay. You can actually eat the skins of all of these squashes. And it's a really nice thing that's local and of the season.
Right, because they are absolutely of the season. All right, let's go over the ingredients so everyone out there knows what we need to make this this recipe today.
Absolutely. So, as I said, we have the three squashes. Mm-hmm. We have a buttercup squash, a delicata, which is an Italian varietal of squash, as well acorn. In addition, we have some charred and pickled Belgian endive. Ooh. To give a little bit of acidity as well as seasonality to this dish. We have some fresh thyme, as well fresh chervil, some crushed garlic cloves, salt, cracked black pepper, the seeds of our squashes, and some fresh pomegranate seeds. As well, we have some toasted pumpkin seed oil.
Nice!
Not something that everyone gets at home, but if you can, it's a really nice ingredient.
And a really good way to add that fall flavor to whatever dish that you're making, right?
And relevant with the squashes.
All right, sounds good to us. We are going to put all this together in just a little bit. Also, they've got battle chefs going on. We're going to talk about battle chefs coming up in just a little bit. Back to you. All right, we are back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. Guy we haven't seen in a while, Jason Kindness, is here. He's got a drink. What are you going to make for us?
I'm going to make a drink we like to call the Shanghai Shrub.
All right.
It's really cool. What we do at Revolving Door, if you haven't been there yet, it's an open kitchen concept.
Nice.
So actually, my bar is behind the kitchen line, so I'm actually with the chef. So what we like to do is incorporate a lot of the food that's being prepared into the cocktails and kind of cross paths here. Now, what we have here is a shrub-style cocktail, and a lot of people talk about Prohibition-era cocktails.
Right.
I take it back even further. This is colonial-era cocktails. So back in the day...
So we're putting on our pilgrim hats for this?
Most definitely. Most
right,
definitely. Tis the season, right?
All right.
So back in the day before they had refrigeration, they used to use vinegar to store a lot of their berries and whatnot. So when they would be done with the vinegar, they'd be left over with this really nice macerated flavored vinegar, and they would actually use it in cocktails.
Wow.
It would be very refreshing and whatnot. So we're going to kind of delve into that a little bit here. And then we also take a little bit of a Thai flavor. So we're going to start off with just a little bit of gin. This is pre-measured, 1 ounce, Julia Child style here. All right, and then we got a little bit of rum as well. Okay, and then fresh citrus. We make our own sour mix in-house.
Okay.
It's a blend of fresh lemon, fresh lime, fresh orange.
And it really makes a difference when making a drink, especially when it's fresh and you know what's actually going into it.
Oh, most definitely, because a lot of times you get sour mix that comes out of the gun. It's from a pre-concentrated mix, and you don't really know what you're getting.
Yep.
And here, you totally know what you're getting here.
So,
and then we have our syrup. Now, the beauty of this is a lot of times we don't have time to put 15 or 20 different ingredients into a cocktail. So what I do
so that's all kind of
cook it into a reduction. This is
blended together.
Lemongrass and ginger. This has the vinegar in it.
Yep.
A little bit of chili paste as well. All the Thai flavors that you really love.
So you're gonna put that in there.
A little bit of that in there, and then we're gonna finish it off with a little bit of Thai basil as well.
Okay.
Got our glassware here. We're gonna pop this on. Give it a good shake.
Mix it up.
A little bit of love in there.
Okay. Shake that
all
in.
Right.
Look at that.
There we go.
Show off.
What it calls for right now, you know what I mean? So then we're going to go on top of here a little bit.
Look at that.
Yep.
That
and then we
great.
Finish this off with a little bit of Thai basil.
And you are good to go. All right.
Absolutely.
All looks good. Jason's here. We're going to get back to cooking with Josh in just a little bit, talk more about the Revolving Door, put the original recipe together. So we've got a lot going on. Back to you. Rhode Show Kitchen, Revolving Door is the restaurant. Josh Berman is the chef today, and he's got a fall menu that he's putting together for us. And we're going to talk about the big event, the Battle Chefs event that's happening too.
Battle Chefs. We're very excited about Battle Chefs. It's kind of something that our restaurant is really almost built for.
Mm-hmm.
We want to be almost like a venue
sure.
where we can do things like this, like kind of we're only limited by imagination. Mm-hmm. So we want to do battle chefs, which is where we'll have 8 chefs from around the state battle it out one-on-one, kind of like a mix between like a quick fire challenge on Top Chef and Chopped.
Okay.
That a lot of people know about.
Now you're talking my language. I am loving this concept. I'm so happy that this is coming right here to Rhode Island. So
when's it going to happen, and how can people get involved?
Okay, so we're starting early November, and it's going to be going for the entire month, going into early December. And really, to get involved, you can call us at our restaurant or stop in. Stop in and check us out.
Is this something that people can view as well? They can watch the battle happen?
We're working on it. You know, this is we're a new restaurant, and we want to have all these things. But I mean, but people will be there. I mean, we have so basically $20 gets you in the door. Yep. You get a cocktail and an hors d'oeuvre, and you know, you watch. We're gonna have our very own Michaela Johnson in as a guest chef.
Nice.
I hope that's official.
Guest chef?
I thought I was judging.
It's all right. I'll work on my skills. Throw me whatever you want. I'll make something.
Well,
out of
we thought judge, but you know. So we throw you a little curveball.
I'm okay with it.
She makes a good pie.
Bring it on. Thank you.
All right.
We gotta get to what we're making here.
Absolutely. So we're doing a scallop dish, which I heard is your favorite.
Yeah, well.
So
it's really
super simple. A lot of local ingredients. Let's get started.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So first we have our
That's
front
okay.
of you.
That's right.
We've got some really nice local scallops. We're gonna season with just a little bit of salt and pepper. On both sides. It's really important. I feel like when people go out to restaurants, they think the food is so much better, but like than what they do at home, they don't know how they can do it. But I feel like a lot of it is properly seasoning things. And
that you bring
and
up
when
a great
it really it, people are like, "Oh my gosh, it looks like you just put so much stuff on there," but it's salt and pepper.
Right.
Mm-hmm. So then we go into a hot black steel pan, which I have here, which is actually carbon steel. It's really nice for getting a really, really hot sear.
Ooh.
Turn this on.
We got a
here.
Sizzle, yeah. We need
Turn
the fan
it on.
For this one.
Okay. And then we go into our hot pan.
And that's key, to get it hot before you place them on there.
It really is, because scallops are so sweet, you know? Mm-hmm. They have the, they caramelize really well. And it's just a really nice thing, especially for the fall when you've got a lot of these other ingredients. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take just a little knob of butter in here.
Okay.
Just a little bit, you know? From here, we can turn down our heat a little bit.
Okay.
Basically, this is for getting, we wanna get nice color and flavor. In here, we're going to do a little bit of fresh thyme. It's gonna pop a little bit as it fries. We're gonna take our spoon, and we're basically just gonna have a little bit of high heat, high fat basting.
Okay.
So we're gonna take our scallops and
kind of move them to one of the sides.
Yeah, you know, we kind of, you know, a lot of people do basting, you know, like with their turkey and things like that. You can baste everything, but in my opinion, I feel like the basting should be a lot of high fat.
Okay. Well, in addition to that, what are we pairing the dish with?
We're pairing the dish with, this is going with, like I said, some of our squashes. So we have a, all of these are local and very easily attainable in the area. So we have kombucha squash, or it's also known as buttercup. We have acorn squash and delicata, which is an Italian varietal.
Which you've already kind of prepared over there just by simply roasting
them.
Okay.
Yeah, which reminds me, let's get these a little bit hot, which is some of our just roasted vegetables.
Would you suggest chopping that into some larger pieces before throwing it in the oven, or do you roast something like that whole because then it's easier to chop?
To be honest, I like to cut them first because they cook a lot faster.
You're talking
10 minutes instead of like 35 minutes.
Because it does take a lot of time for that to go. All right, give the address of the restaurant itself, too.
Okay, so we're at 509 Thames Street.
Right.
Right in downtown Newport. Also, I wanted to talk a little bit about the chefs that we have coming in for the battle chefs. We've got a few in there, actually. Jay Barrasso from the Chop House Grill. We have Jim Collarin from 22 Bowens, also in Newport, Rhode Island. As well, Jake Rojas from the fame Tallulah.
Very good.
We'll make sure that we post all those names and even more information about the Revolving Door and that upcoming Battle Chef epic event. That smells phenomenal. You're going to want the recipe on WPRI.com.